What's up? How y'all doing? For this episode of Sitcom Revisited, we're going to count down my favorite episodes from The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. This sitcom ran from September 10, 1990 to May 20th, 1996. And honestly, it's literally one of my favorite sitcoms of all time growing up. You know, this was the show that really catapulted Will Smith's acting career. You know what I'm saying? A lot of talent came from this show. Joseph Marcel, James Avery, Alfonso Ribeiro. You know what I'm saying? So, but what are the best episodes? You know what I'm saying? What are the episodes that really stand out? So let's get right into it, because some of these episodes may surprise you on this list. So let's get right into it. So we're going to start off with season one, which in my opinion is probably like another great season. You know what I'm saying? Nice first season to the show. We're going to start off with the first episode of Fresh Prince Project, aka the pilot episode. You know what I'm saying? So this is a nice intro to the characters and the plot. It picks up exactly where the theme song left off at. You know what I'm saying? Will Smith wearing the same clothes. You know what I'm saying? Nice introduction to all the characters on the show. You know, nice little plot, like nice little talk about the haves and the have-nots. You know, this whole pilot literally should be considered one of the top 10 pilots or first episodes, whatever you want to call it, of all time. Little trivia, though. Debbie Allen actually directed this episode, and the power to be, aka the people at NBC, they almost dropped Alfonso Ribeiro, but Debbie Allen put a foot down saying that Alfonso should stay on the show and stuff like that too. Also, another little trivia, the scene when Will and Uncle Phil had that standoff after, you know, the whole party, the scene where Will goes to the piano and plays like Fur Elise, that was actually ad-libbed and not scripted. You know what I'm saying? So they actually left it in there. And I felt like that's definitely a powerful statement of the show, because the way how Uncle Phil was looking at him, he looked at him like he had potential. So this is a standout episode, and I love it. Now, we're going to go on to episode 3, Chubba Bubba. So this is an episode I never hear anybody talk about as like one of their favorites. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like it's a very, very, very traditional episode, I admit. However, you still have a lot of versatile acting from Will Smith, how he goes from playing this preppy student to like this thug or whatever, you know what I'm saying? You have guest appearances from Victoria Royale. You know, you guys should know her. She played Drusilla on The Young Restless. And the late, great Richard Roundtree. You know what I'm saying? Everyone knows Richard Roundtree. Daft. You know what I'm saying? Also, this is actually the first episode to have a scene of dialogue before the opening credits, the cold open, you know what I'm saying? And this is just an early episode of the early shenanigans between Will and Carlton. So, still a great episode. Episode 4, Not With My Pig, You Don't. So, I'm always a fan whenever they have the extended family come along. And this is like the first episode because they had Philip's parents. You know, Philip's parents come on the show, you know what I'm saying? His parents played by Gilbert Lewis, who was the father, pretty much his only appearance. Virginia Capers, who played his mom, Hattie. So, you know, Uncle Phil's about to win this award. And, you know, he pretty much, you know, wants to put up a front. Well, not like a front, but he wants to spice some things up. But then you had the journalist, who actually was portrayed by Kathy Griffin. Not a lot of people know that. She was about to decline the interview. However, Will came up and sold some stories, some childhood memories of Uncle Phil. And Uncle Phil didn't really appreciate that, you know what I'm saying? Which causes a feud between him and his mom. And yeah, this is definitely a very great episode. And it shows a lot of development for Uncle Phil. So, yeah. Very, very, very great episode. Nice. So, number 6, we got Mistaken Identity. Written by the show creators and directed by Jeff Melman, who Jeff Melman would pretty much direct all the episodes, unless noted, on the season, you know what I'm saying? So, this is what I call probably the first dramatic episode of the show. So, Will and Carlton are out, and they actually got stopped by a cop, you know, just a sense of racial profiling, and ended up getting thrown in jail, you know what I'm saying? One thing I loved about this episode was that it combined a lot of solid comedy with a lot of heavy drama. But it does not go overboard with the two, if that makes sense. for example, like I love the scene when Will and Carlton are in the prison and they end up being encountered by this prisoner who just starts singing show tunes or whatever. And then, you know, the dramatic scene when Will confronts Carlton because he felt like Carlton did not learn his lesson when he said the cops were just doing his job. I mean, this episode just proves the show has something to say. And they will have a few more dramatic episodes in the future, but none as contemporary as this one. So in episode 13 of the season, we got Knowledge is Power. Now, this is what I call a Hillary-centric, probably the first Hillary-centric episode on the show. So Will got mad because Hillary got him grounded, and he wants payback on her. So he found out some shit from a college that she actually dropped out. So he blackmails Hillary into doing like his chores or whatever. But then Hillary tells Carlton, and Carlton wants a piece of the action too. So now it's like Hillary being blackmailed by Carlton and Will. Karen Parsons definitely does a great job in this episode, and the dinner scene is a fucking classic. You know what I'm saying? So definitely a favorite of mine. Then we get to episode 14, Day Damn One. Now, this is actually the third episode that was produced, and you can kind of tell because of James Avery not having the beard yet. So they actually redid this, and it pretty much tells Will telling Ashley and the girls a story about his first appearance in the private school. And yeah, this is another great episode that explores the fish out of water and everything like that, the fish out of water concept. And then you had Will, you know, being a hit with all of his peers and whatnot too. So this definitely had a lot of great moments. I love the appearances from his friend Cornflake, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, man, this episode right here is a very underrated episode. I don't hear a lot of people mention this one as their favorites. And personally, I don't know about you, but I feel like it could easily have been a third episode of the series. But at the same time, too, I love the Chubba Bubba episode. So now we have episode 19, It Had to Be You. You know what I'm saying? This one right here is actually Jazz asking Will to date his overbearing sister, played by Vivica A. Fox, his future Independence Day co-star. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, this episode was very, very, very funny. You know what I'm saying? I loved the scene when, you know, Will realized that his sister was a tyrant and everything like that too. So what does he do? He tries to put up with Carlton, but then Carlton ends up putting her in check and everything like that too, you know what I'm saying? So this is very, very, very funny episode, and I definitely would recommend it. So now we have the next episode, which is Bank Shot. This is actually my favorite episode of this season. You know what I'm saying? And it definitely highlights the dynamic between the Will and Phil relationship. So Aunt Viv leaves for the weekend, and Uncle Phil is put in charge of the kids. So Will is asked to go to a pool hall, but, you know, he can't go, you know what I'm saying? So he ends up going anyway, and he ends up losing the car. So Uncle Phil and Jeffrey have to go down and help. And the way how Uncle Phil pretty much plays these motherfuckers is just hilarious and stuff like that too. I'm not even going to reveal it, but let's just say that there's more to meet the eye when it comes to Uncle Phil. But yeah, this is a very great episode. My personal favorite, and it definitely highlights one of the most important relationships on the show. Now the next episode, 72 Hours. Now, Bank Shot may have been my favorite episode of the season, but 72 Hours, in my opinion, is the funniest episode of the season, mostly due to Alfonso Ribeiro's performance. So Will bets Carlton that he can't last a weekend in Compton, you know what I'm saying, Jazz's neighborhood. Next thing you know it, Carlton takes the bet too far, and he starts, you know, acting out and everything like that too. So Will ends up going to see Uncle Phil and Aunt Vivian to help him out. And pretty much, you know, Aunt Vivian comes down there and just, you know, reads them for filth. So yeah, this was a very great episode. And yeah, man, it just shows, just like with Uncle Phil, it shows that there's more to meet that when it comes to Carlton character. So yeah, this is actually a funny episode. So now we're going to go into the second season, which the second season is possibly my favorite season of the show. You know what I'm saying? I felt like all the characters were definitely at peak form with this one. So we're going to go into the first episode of the second season, which is The Earth Move For You. One of the funniest episodes of the series. This is the episode when there's like an earthquake, when they were on their way to go to, I think, the People's Choice Awards or whatever. You had an appearance from a young Tisha Campbell, who plays one of Will's girlfriends. You know what I'm saying? It also has a traditional landscape of like the Banks' residence and stuff like that, you know, with the whole white decor. Because, you know, the previous decor, well, I liked the previous decor, but it felt a bit more gloomy. It felt more 80s like. I feel this layout definitely shouted out the 90s more, in my opinion. So then we have The Mother of All Battles, the second episode. Where, just to let you know, almost all these episodes in the season was directed by Ellen Falcon. So this is actually one of the more funnier Ashley episodes, because nothing against Tatiana Ali. She's a very dope actress and comedian. But a lot of her episodes do kind of tend to be on a more preachy side, and sometimes can go to the very special episode length. Not saying that's a bad thing, but sometimes when, you know, I want to watch a comedy, I want to laugh. Sometimes too, unless if it's noted. And yeah, this episode just pretty much shows, you know, Ashley being bullied by a girl and shit like that too. So, you know, Will and Carlton try to help her out. A lot of classic dialogue in this whole episode, you know what I'm saying? Then once the parents got involved, the comedy just escalates, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man, this is a very, very, very funny episode. Episode number 6, we got Guess Who's Coming to Mary. You know, this written by Sam Art Williams, you know what I'm saying, who would end up, you know, doing work in shows like Martin and Living Single. This is another episode where they have the extended family members. This time you meet Vivian's sisters, like Renee Watson, Jennifer Lewis, the great Jennifer Lewis, you know what I'm saying? And Charlene Woodard, who plays Janice, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, Janice is actually going to marry a white man, but she caught the family by surprise. And this is another one of those topical episodes that shows how interracial dating was not fully accepted at that time, too. And Vernie Watson, who plays Will's mom, was to me the MVP of this episode, because, you know, she had it rough the most. And she says she or Will is not going to come to the wedding, but then she ends up turning away and change her mind later on and stuff like that too. So yeah, this is a very, very, very great episode. A little trivia: this is actually the first episode of the show where the egg actually played, you know, when the credits were rolling, you know what I'm saying? They actually had a scene in the end credits. Alright, so episode 7, The Big 4-0. This is, in my opinion, Janet Hubert's best episode on the show, and possibly her best season too, just based on the performance that she was given. So we all know this episode. This is the episode where Vivian turns 40 years old, and pretty much, you know, she's going through like a midlife crisis, so she wants to take up dancing like this is a dream of hers. So she ends up fucking up in the first try, but then next thing you know, she caught some confidence. And let's just say we all know the scene, the classic dance scene to CNC, Everybody Dance Now, I'm Gonna Make You Sweat. Love that record. Janet Hubert definitely did a thing on this one. And as iconic as this scene is, and a testament to its iconicness, I remember an episode of Wild and Out when they were coming trying to compare the two Aunt Vivs, and one of the guys, I forgot who it was, he's like, light-skinned Aunt Viv can't do this, and he tried to dance like her and stuff like that. Definitely one of my favorite Wild and Out skits of all time. So now we're going to go to episode 9, Cased Up. So this is an episode Uncle Phil's protege Eric, who was dating Hillary, wants to sue Will after causing an accident out in his car. Now, as much as I love Malcolm Jamal Warner, and as much as I feel like this episode is very, very, very solid, I do have to admit the real reason why I picked this episode is because of the performance of Jazzy Jeff. I feel like this is definitely one of his most funniest appearances on the show. He just had a field day. So whether it's like getting thrown in and out the house, you know, taking his fucking glasses off when trying to flirt with Hillary. You know, pretty much in the courtroom, you know, putting his hands up when the bailiff tries to swear him in. I mean, this episode definitely would have been lackluster if it wasn't for Jazz, in my personal opinion. Even though it was still a well-written episode, I feel like Jazz definitely stole the show. Now, episode 11 of the second season, The Butler Did It. You know what I'm saying? This is actually my favorite episode of the season. This is one of those episodes where it's like chaos, front and back, front and back, front and back. So Uncle Phil and Aunt Viv goes away for the weekend, and this leaves Hillary in charge. And so Carlton has an idea of having a Belle Biv DeVoe music video in the Banks' residence. You know, at this time, Belle Biv DeVoe was about to promote what was to be the latest single called Gangsta. I've done a review on the Hootie Mac album, so y'all can go check out the story with that. And pretty much, you know, Uncle Phil and Alviria is trying to come home a little bit early because there's like disruptants, a lot of disruptants when it comes to like a neighbor next door, which ends up being Jeffrey. And so it's just a farce with how they try to put everything together, you know, with the furniture and everything like that too. You know what I'm saying? So this is definitely a favorite episode of mine. So many classic moments came from the show. Yeah, nothing bad about it. 12. Something for Nothing. This is actually one of the most underrated and quieter episodes of the show, especially with a season where like a lot was happening. And it's an episode where Will wins at this charity auction, and he's not going to give it money back, and which causes a lot of anger between Uncle Phil. But then you pretty much have there's a reason why he's not going to be giving the money back or whatnot too, because he actually donated this friend so he can go to basketball camp. You know what I'm saying? Very, very, very great episode. It just goes to show you that Will, you know, while still standing on his own ground, it does not mean he's discrediting Uncle Phil's message or whatnot of giving back to the community. You know what I'm saying? And I also love the subplot between Jeffrey and Ashley when they were playing poker. So, you know what I'm saying? So, definitely a very great episode. 19. We got Eyes on the Prize. Very, 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 very funny episode. You know what I'm saying? This season actually has one of Will's other friends, Ty. And this is actually the only time Ty and Jazz has an episode, and they are just funny as hell together. So Will wants to go on this game show and whatnot, and it's like you do stupid shit, you know what I'm saying? And so he originally wanted to ask Cornflake, but pretty much Cornflake, let's just say, he got an offer he couldn't refuse. That's all I want to say. And so, you know, Jazz and Ty are trying to compete just to be Will's game show partner, but Will ends up picking Carlton. You know what I'm saying? So Ty and Jazz actually team up together just to get back at Will. So this one is a very, very, very funny ass episode. A lot of dope quotables on this one. And the last episode. And Uncle in Bel Air. I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. And the last episode of season 2, Striptease for 2. Now, this is another episode that I consider a classic, in my opinion. So, Will and Carlton got into stocks, and they pretty much lost a lot of stock after, you know, pawning one of Aunt Viv's silver. Meanwhile, Hillary and Aunt Viv were trying to get into like the society club for women and stuff like that too. So in order for Will and Carlton to get back the stock and the money, they have to strip to get it, which the society club was going to be in a strip club as well too. Very funny episode. This is the classic episode that was known for, you know, Carlton doing his little strip dance or whatever. But the funniest part was when Uncle Phil got into his explosions. One of his best explosions, in my opinion. Do I look like a white guy named Ward? Yeah, this episode is definitely a classic episode when it comes to the series. Alright, moving on to season 3, my second favorite season. We're going to start off with the episode, How I Spent My Summer Vacation. Now, this was written by Winfred Hervey Stalworth and directed by Shelley Jensen. One of the funniest and enjoyable episodes of the series. You know what I'm saying? Will comes back from Philly, and Uncle Phil does not like the beep or the hairstyle and stuff like that, too. Despite it being very funny, it does have like a lot of undertones with like a lot of like the stereotypical black man, especially, you know, after the whole LA riots and whatnot too, you know, because it definitely shed a light on, you know, Phil thinking that Will was still going to go to his hidden ways and whatnot too, because mind you, their relationship at this point was still not really close, if that makes sense too. The ending was very funny, I'm not going to hold you. I kind of consider it their Cosby Show ending, you know what I'm saying? And the reason why I say that, it was because I know a lot of fans did not like the fact that, you know, what's his name? Phil and Vivian still grounded the kids and whatnot too. But if you remember like the Cosby Show episode, the pilot, where Theo made that speech and whatnot, and he thought that, you know, the parents was going to turn the leaf. And you can be sadly mistaken because of the fact that, you know, Phil and Vivian weren't having none of that shit. You know what I'm saying? So, very great episode. A great episode, especially when it comes to character and plot. Moving on, we're going to go to the third episode of the season. That's No Lady, That's My Cousin. Arguably the funniest Ashley episode in the series. But it's still not away from its preachiness, you know, but I can deal with this kind of preachiness. So, you know, another important development was the fact that, you know, the private school got co-sex, you know, because Will and Carlton used to go to an all-guys private school, but now it's like now they're going to integrate like more women there. So, again, very great development. And Ashley, who was just starting high school, if I know, you know, she wants to develop more, wants to be with the good, because she saw how Will Carlton and their friend, played by Lorenz Tate, you know what I'm saying, was just hawking at the girls and whatnot. The funniest scene was when Will and Carlton was in the cafeteria and Carlton looked at this girl and Will's like, that's your baby sister, man. You know what I'm saying? And Carlton just screams and whatnot. Very funny scene. You know what I'm saying? It does kind of show a lesson towards the end, you know what I'm saying, with the conversation between Will and Ashley, but at the same time, you know, it still maintains its comedic tone. Also, another subplot, we have Hillary moving into the pool house, you know what I'm saying? And this is a very, very, very key step into her development, because the fact that when it comes to Hillary, people always want to put the dumb persona on her, but at the same time, too, she has a way of she can actually use her own smarts to her own gain or just outwit Phil and Vivian when the time comes for it. Very great episode. Episode 5, Mama's Baby, Carlton's Maybe. This has Lark Voorhees, aka Lisa Turtle from Saved by the Bell, you know, playing Carlton's girlfriend who comes out saying that she's having his baby, or she had his baby or whatever. Very funny episode, one of the boldest episodes of the series, you know what I'm saying? And the reason why I say that is because of the fact that, you know, this was the fact that they still were in high school. And the fact that, you know, Uncle Phil and Aunt Vivian being prominent, the thought of Carlton, you know, having a child out of wedlock and whatnot too, very, very, very bold. But you know what, they handled this very well. Thank God it didn't go too dramatic. But yeah, this episode has been very funny moments. I think the funniest moment to me was when Janet Hubert was strangling Carlton, trying to get him to tell the truth and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, man, very, very, very great episode. Then we got episode 6 of the season, P.S. I Love You. So, I'm going to be real. The plot of this episode is Will taking advantage of this girl, who this girl likes him and she keeps giving him gifts. It's a very funny plot. I've seen a lot of people kind of say it was a bit mean-spirited, and it just dives into some of the mean-spirited tones of this show, which I'll get more into that as the review goes on. But I feel like he was still in character, because, you know, Will was just doing his thing. But the real reason why this episode is on the list is because it starts off the arc of Philip running for judge, and he has to run against his old mentor, you know, which was played by Sherman Hemsley, who played his own mentor, Carl Robinson. You know what I'm saying? Sherman Hemsley definitely did his thing with his character, and the arc was very funny, mostly because of his chemistry between Sherman and James Avery. And yeah, man, you definitely had like a lot of great jokes in this episode. Very, very, very funny. Then we have episode 8 of the season, Boys in the Woods, written by one of the best writers of the show, Sam Art Williams, and this time directed by Chuck Vinson. This is actually my favorite episode of the season. People might be surprised because, you know, season 3 had like a lot of standout episodes. But the reason why I like this more quieter episode is because it reveals a lot of personal gains when it comes to Will and Phil and even Carlton. You know what I'm saying? And the episode goes that, you know, Uncle Phil wants to take Will and Carlton on this camping trip before they go to college. They end up getting lost, but then they find a large sum of money and shit like that too. And then, of course, Uncle Phil makes Will burn the money, even though, spoiler alert, he didn't actually burn. He still kept that shit at the end. But the reason why I love this episode, because it reveals a lot about Will and Phil with their intimate conversations. And I feel like this was the moment that they really was like breaking down the barriers, you know what I'm saying? You know, Will talking about, you know, how Phil was like a father to him and shit like that too. But at the same time too, it still had its funny moments. Like, we all remember the scene where Carlton was like, he had his own moment and he said, the silly rabbit tricks up for kids, why can't they give him some cereal? And then even the subplot between Hillary, Trevor, Jazz, and Jeffrey, when Hillary and Trevor trying to have some alone time and Jazz keeps interrupting and whatnot too. I'm gonna be real with you, I don't even find a character Trevor that funny, but depending on the episode and the plot, like this one, I can definitely tolerate him. And of course, you know, you had Jazz, so that's already a given. So episode 10, Ashes to Ashes. Possibly my second favorite episode of the season, probably the funniest of the season. You know what I'm saying? This is pretty much the conclusion of the arc between Judge Robinson and Uncle Phil. You know what I'm saying? And it's pretty much, you know, Judge Robinson beating Uncle Phil in the race of judge, and he ends up disrespecting Uncle Phil in front of his followers. However, Phil confronts him, he has a heart attack and he dies. You know what I'm saying? You know, this episode reminds me of a Jeffersons episode, ironically, called Dearly Beloved. You know what I'm saying? Which, that episode had George confronting his employee that's never had a good reputation when it comes to his customers, and he ends up dying in his home, and then he has to do a whole eulogy or whatever too, you know what I'm saying? This episode is very unique, and it's an iconic episode for a lot of reasons. One, you had Uncle Phil becoming a judge, which would be his like prominent career as the show goes on. Two, you have Carlton dancing to Tom Jones for the first time in the series and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? And three, it's damn funny. It's literally one of the funniest episodes of the series. Little trivia. Sherman Hemsley, old A-man co-star Barbara Montgomery, actually plays mistress at the funeral, so you know what I'm saying? So that's a little trivia and side note. Very great episode. Episode 12, we got the Cold War. You know what I'm saying? Written by David Steven Simon and Michael Peters. This is another episode where a lot of fans kind of say it's a bit too mean-spirited. You know, he has Carlton with the flu, and Will ends up, you know, messing around with his girlfriend and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? And then Will ends up getting the flu, and they end up staying in the pool house so everybody won't get sick. You know, a lot of fans kind of have some mixed feelings about this episode when I looked up. A lot of fans say this is like one of the funniest episodes, and there's some fans that say it was kind of out of character for Will and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? Me personally, I feel like it's a very solid episode around. You know, I felt like, you know, was it messed up what Will did? Yeah. But at the same time too, you know what I'm saying? It's the fact that, you know, Will's always been a womanizer and shit like that too, so anything for that, you know? Yeah, this is a solid episode. In episode 13, we have Mommy Nearest. Now again, I love episodes when the extended family comes together. You know what I'm saying? It's especially when you have the talents of Renee Watson and Jennifer Lewis. You know, with this episode, it pretty much features Will's mama wanting to move closer to Will and shit like that too. And I feel like this episode is very underrated because I, you know, try to adjust to Will's life and Will adjusting to his life in Bel-Air. You know what I'm saying? Now, I'm not going to hold you. I did feel like the daydream when they were older or whatnot too, I kind of felt like it wasn't really needed. But, you know, it's still a very funny episode. So, I can take it. Now, episode 14, Winner Takes All. Oh, Jesus, man. This is pretty much a consecutive run right here. But I'm going to take that. I'm going to take this back. I love Ashes to Ashes, but this is actually my second favorite episode of the season. This episode is hilarity from front to back. So Will and Carlton want to get back at Jeffrey for, you know, a car trip. So they make him believe that he won the lottery and shit like that too, you know what I'm saying? And so they actually taped last week's episode. And so when Jeffrey wins, you have a tour de force performance from Joseph Marcel that is very, very, very great. And, you know, when it comes to the Jeffrey episodes, even though there's not as many as Ashley episodes, because a lot of Jeffrey plots are mostly relegated to subplots, he had a few episodes here and there, but a lot of them kind of wanted to focus on, like, the more personal development, which, again, was great. I don't mind that. You know what I'm saying? But sometimes a comedy can be inconsistent when it comes to those, you know what I'm saying? But this one is probably Joseph Marcel's best episode in Fresh Prince history. And I feel like it's another standout episode from the show. You know what I'm saying? I love the scene when he just goes crazy when he thought he won the lottery. And once he realized that it was a trick, he felt embarrassed and he quit the job. So Uncle Phil forces Will and Carlton to get him back. You know, this was actually written by Casey Maxwell Clare, a very great writer on the show. You know what I'm saying? So, yes. So episode. Now we have the episode Just Say Yo. Yeah, this is the very special episode where, you know, Carlton accidentally takes some pills, you know, some speed that was, you know, originally Will's, but he mistaken it for vitamin E. Now, usually, when it comes to very special episodes, they can be very hit or miss sometimes. There's been some good ones, there's been some bad ones. Some of the very special episodes I don't like because sometimes it disregards some of the character's intelligence. However, this episode is definitely one of the better very special episodes I've done, mostly based on the acting, most specifically from Will Smith, as you see his character, you know, struggle with the guilt of almost, you know, killing, well, inadvertently killing his cousin over some drugs and stuff. Will Smith definitely gave a very great performance, and I consider this episode of What's to Come. Stay tuned.
So,
in the last episode from season 3, episode 20 is The Baby Comes Out, another episode written by Winifred Hervey Stallworth. Now, when it comes to Janet Huber, you know, her pregnancy, you know, towards the latter half of the season, she was like many limited performances, a limited episode, excuse me. And some of the later episodes of season 3 kind of was not really hitting like that, you know what I'm saying? Especially, I didn't really care for the D.L. Hughley episode. But this one was a nice pace. This is the episode where Nikki is finally born, you know what I'm saying? And Janet Huber definitely did a thing on this episode. I love how anytime he grabs somebody's hand, you know, she ends up, you know, just squeezing it because of the contraptions and whatnot, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, probably her last standout performance on the show, unfortunately. Moving on to season 4. So this is the infamous season right here. This is the infamous season. So this is the season where Janet Huber got fired, and then you have Daphne Maxwell Reed portraying a new Aunt Viv, aka Viv 2. This season, you definitely had Will and Carlton going to college and everything. And you have a lot more darker episodes of the show too. Now, I'm going to be real with you. I feel like this season's always been underrated. Believe it or not, I've always felt like the season has always been underrated. And the reason why I say that is because the fact that people focus on the controversy between Jada Pinkett and Will Smith, which thank God that they squashed their beef. However, I felt like this episode just has a lot of strong episodes, you know what I'm saying? And Will Smith was very influenced by Roseanne, that he wanted it to have like a lot more dramatic episodes of the show too. And originally too, what a lot of people don't know was the fact that this was actually the season of the show. Stay tuned on that. We'll talk more about that in a minute. But yes. So we're gonna start off with the first episode. So we're gonna get started with the second episode of the fourth season, where there's a will, there's a way. You know what I'm saying? So season four opens up with one-hour season premiere with Will and Carlton in college, you know what I'm saying? Part one was pretty cool. I like part one. It was just setting the tone. It was really just setting the tone for everything. And, you know, Carlton being the mascot, you know, Will and Carlton getting the place on their own. But part two is where the comedy really, really shines, you know what I'm saying? And it features, you know, Will getting reacquainted to his old childhood friend Jackie, portrayed by Tyra Banks. And Tyra Banks, you know, she did a thing. She was in like a couple of episodes in the fourth season. And pretty much, you know what I'm saying, Carlton thought that he was going out with her. But once he found out that Will actually known her and whatnot too, you know what I'm saying, that's when, you know, a lot of history comes between them. And you definitely had, in this season, a lot of history with a lot of Philly reference in this season, and just exposing his life more in Philly, which I'll get more into that in a minute. And but the real funny thing of the episode of this, I mean the real funny part of this episode is when Hillary actually was waiting for a proposal from Trevor, and pretty much Trevor actually wanted to do a bungee jump proposal, don't ask. And he ends up pretty much, you know, just dying from that. And yeah, it's fucked up. It's a very, very dark comedic twist. But it features, you know, Will and Carlton. Will and Carlton actually moving to the pool house because Hillary did not want to be around any memories of Trevor. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, this was a very, very, very funny episode. Love it. So episode three is All Guts, No Glory. This is another underrated episode, and it just features Will's journey in college. You know, he pretty much, you know, wants to apply to the psychology class, of course, for a girl, of course. And, you know, he ends up, you know, bullshitting his way through college. You know, Jim Meskimen, he plays the teacher, you know what I'm saying? But he ends up actually having a role later on in the series as Will's boss and producer for Hillary's talk show, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, his character was entertaining here, you know what I'm saying? But the real eye-opener of this episode was Uncle Phil snapping some sense into Will because of the fact that he feels like he's wasting his potential and bullshitting his way in college, and his Will just snaps back into focus, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, very, very, very dope. And then you have episode five of this season. You have It's Better to Have Loved and Lost It. You know what I'm saying? One of my favorite Carlton episodes, and a very standout episode for Alfonso Ribeiro. This episode is a development for Carlton because of the fact that he lost his virginity to a woman that's unbeknownst to him is actually married to the guy that he wants to, you know, apply to Princeton and shit like that too. You know what I'm saying? So this was a very, very, very dope episode, and I love the performance Alfonso Ribeiro did. You know what I'm saying? How he goes from just ecstatic that he lost his virginity, thinking he found the love of his life, to, you know, just back down being embarrassed by the fact that she pretty much just used his ass. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. Also, the Jeffrey subplot is also funny as hell, too. You know what I'm saying? About why he actually came to London. You know what I'm saying? So, I guess with the writers thinking that this is going to be their last season, they want to explore a lot more characters. You know what I'm saying? So, I'll accept it. episode 6, Will goes a courting. So we all know the whole Rashinamata plot where everybody tells different situations of what actually happened. Well, this episode kind of takes a bit unique because of the fact that they don't actually go to that part until after the event happened. Kind of like, you know, the Different World episode, Cats in the Cradle. But thank God, this is actually more funnier. Not saying that Cats in the Cradle was a bad episode, but it's actually one of my favorites from that season. But y'all can go watch the review for that one. So Uncle Phil wants to pretty much, you know, ban Will and Carlton from this pool party because, you know, Will and Carlton said that it is no AC in a pool house and shit like that too, you know what I'm saying? Because they're trying to throw a party. So, you know, Uncle Phil actually takes them to court because of the fact that they say they're not going to pay any rent. So this episode is very funny. You know, I love how they each have their own version of what actually happened. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, it's a very, very, very solid episode all the way through. Moving on, we have Blood is Thicker Than Mud. My second favorite episode of this season. And probably Alfonso Ribeiro's best performance of this episode. You know what I'm saying? So, Will and Carlton both want to go into the fraternity. And the fraternity pretty much wants to put Carlton in the ringer because of the fact of his privileged lifestyle. And so, Carlton, you know, he does everything. He gets down and dirty and he actually tries to prove to everybody that, you know, he can do it. But at the end, the guy only picks Will. He does not pick Carlton because of the fact of his rich lifestyle. It's kind of a fucked up thing, but it is what it is. And Carlton just pretty much just says that, you know, how can you talk about you for our people, but then you over here doing this bullshit, you know what I'm saying? So I would definitely, definitely, definitely recommend this episode. It's definitely one of the more dramatic episodes of this season, but I definitely love it. So, yeah. Episode 14, yeah, Sleepless in Bel-Air. You know, written by Maya Williams and directed by Shelley Jensen. This episode is pretty much just a farce all the way throughout. You know what I'm saying? Will and Carlton are trying to get some work done, and Will is trying to study for an exam. But everyone can't sleep because of a cricket, and then Ashley is sneaking out. You know what I'm saying? So, also, too, Hillary also is in this fucking coffee addicted mode after doing some coffee ads. It's a very funny episode, and it's also one of the times the show actually went into full farce mode. I definitely love it. Moving on, we have the infamous yet very, very, very great episode, Papa's Got a Brand New Excuse. You know what I'm saying? And this has been said by a lot of fans and critics to be the best episode of the series, which I have to agree, you know what I'm saying, because of the fact that it shows Will pretty much, you know, confronting his feelings about his father once he returns to his life, you know what I'm saying. And, you know, throughout this season, you have a lot more mentions of, you know, of Will's father, and, you know, especially in the episode when Uncle Phil has his heart attack, and he asked Carlton, you know, where my father is. Well, I don't know. So this is actually the highest rated episode of the series. And even Will Smith said this is actually his favorite episode of the series too, you know what I'm saying, because of the feelings of his father. And one thing about this episode was the fact that even though it had a lot of jokes, but it didn't have too many jokes, you know what I'm saying, it definitely told a story right straight through. Ben Vereen actually plays Will's father. Originally, Lawrence Fishburne was supposed to play Will's father, but I think the producer that his approach is a bit more laid back. Ben Vereen definitely just thinking this episode, and he said that after he walked off the set when he left Will, he even cried himself because he felt like he can't even do that to his own son if he had one. But yeah, man. We all remember the scene when Will pretty much goes on that tirade and whatnot to finally confront his feelings when his father leaves again. I definitely, definitely, definitely love Will Smith's performance, and James Avery definitely held his own on that episode too. So, yeah, man, very, very, very great episode. The best episode not only in this season, but of the whole series. Now, episode 26, we have the Philadelphia Story. So, originally, this is actually supposed to have been the series finale, to be real with you. And it was supposed to have been like, you know, the family going back to Philadelphia and Will realizing that, you can't leave home. And also the fact that, he's finally wanting to confront this bully that actually, made a fool out of him and made him actually go to Bel-Air in the first place. So one thing I liked about this episode is the fact of the matter is that it shows a lot of, character development when it comes to Will, you know what I'm saying? And it's a very, very risky idea for him to go back home, you know what I'm saying? Go back home and realizing that at the end of the series, you know what I'm saying? But, I don't know. It was just very, very, very abrupt, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, too, it's a very, very, very nice and solid way if they ended up closing the series with that. And the real reason why that is not actually the last season is actually because a lot of fans wrote to NBC and Will Smith that how much they loved the show. So they renewed the show for another season. And ironically, this was also supposed to have been our last season. So season 5 is a very interesting season because of the fact that, the main storyline of this season is the fact that, Will meets Lisa, who's supposed to have been the love of his life, and they end up, getting engaged by the end of the season, only for them to not get married. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, we'll talk more about that. And I did like Nia Long's performance as Lisa. I felt like Lisa was kind of like a breath of fresh air. And a lot of the episodes when it comes to their relationships are very, very, very funny as well, as well as character revealing. But it just kind of sucks that I'm just gonna spoil it out for you right now. I did not like the last episode of the season. You know what I'm saying? Because of the fact that, hey, Will and Lisa did not get married, but let's marry off Will's mother and Lisa's father, even though we don't see Lisa's father no more. And they just met for like 2 days and stuff like that, Not gonna hold you. Not gonna hold you. Yes, it was funny seeing Will Smith, seeing them in bed together. It was funny. I love that scene, but that's to me the worst episode of the series. I'm just gonna say that right now. But just getting that out of the way. So episode 6, Will's Misery. This is the first episode of the whole Will Lisa arc. Now I'm gonna spoil you alert. Season 5 started off with a couple of weak episodes too. The episode with Ashley's singing career. Yeah, I love that song that she did, but I felt like the episode was very, very, very flat and it kind of. A lot of characters were kind of out of character, but y'all can watch the episode for itself. Then you had the episode where Nikki realized that his mascot was a fake. I mean, not his mascot. Nikki realized that his favorite TV character was not real, and Will has to tell him that. But his family said, "Don't tell him." I mean, this was the episode when I forgot. This was the season when Ross Backlee was growing up, Nikki. I'm not gonna hold you. I didn't really care for a lot of Nikki episodes. This is included. And then you also have the episode when, Will and Carlton, pretty much fight over a girl after the girl prefers Carlton over Will. The actress was fine. Not gonna hold you, but yeah, we've seen this plot before plenty of times. Let's just be real with you. But moving on, Will's Misery. Yeah, I'm very critical of this season. Yeah, Will's Misery. It's very, very, very funny episode. It's the first episode of Will and Lisa arc. You know what I'm saying? Lisa trying to play a prank on Will at the fact with Hell Carlton's help. And, we have this scene where she tries to make Will think that she's crazy, only for Will to turn the tables on her. And then realizing that Carlton was behind it the whole time, too. So, I'm gonna be real with you. I'm gonna be real. This is a very funny episode. But I feel like this season was very broad compared to the previous. And I feel like you can tell they were very influenced by like the Fox shows, especially Martin. And there's like some scenes when it comes to this season that feels like more sketch-like. And then you have the scene, well, two scenes in particular where Will traps himself. And you see, remember the scene where he's like hanging and the sorority girls are just laughing at him. And then you also have the infamous but funny scene where Carlton just runs across the fourth wall. And everything like that too. You know what I'm saying? Which again, funny scenes, but this is some shit you would expect from like Martin as well too. You know what I'm saying? But not not saying that it's the best. It's the '90s or whatever. So a lot of shows were just being more broader and whatnot. So yeah. Then we have the seventh episode of the season, Father Knows Best. This is actually an Ashley episode, where Ashley actually transfers to public school without telling Uncle Phil and Aunt Vivian. Believe it or not, I actually like this episode. You know, it's not preachy. You know what I'm saying? It's very, very funny throughout story. And Will pretending that he's Uncle Phil, you know, and that fake getup is pretty entertaining as well, too. So, yeah, I recommend it. Then you have episode 9, Love Hurts. Now, if there was one episode that kind of goes to my, you know, the show was very influenced by Martin, it would be this episode. So, Will and Lisa were pretty much, you know, enjoying their union together. And they were at the party. They were at a bowling alley. And a guy pretty much confronts Will. And he pretty much punches Will dead in the face. And Will pretty much, you know, it takes a while for Will to get out. Because, you know, Will Smith was pretty much, you know, ad-libbing some shit. And, yeah, you know, Will, Lisa pretty much saves his ass. And Will just gets embarrassed by that. And we all seen this plot before. Let's fake somebody getting hurt and you be his hero scenario. So, yeah, this episode is very broad, as you can see. And shit like that, too, you know what I'm saying? A lot of scenes kind of felt sketch-like. Pat Morita, he actually guest stars in this episode, of course, as like a Karate Kid mentor-esque role. And pretty much what happened was, you know what I'm saying, Will ends up breaking a coffee table or some shit, you know what I'm saying? Very, very, very funny scene. Yeah, you know, this is a very funny episode, but at the same time, too, I'm just like, would they ever have done this episode, like, in a season 2 or 3? You never know. So, episode 12 of the season is Same Game Next Season. You know what I'm saying? This is actually the first appearance of John Amos, who plays Lisa's father. Probably his funniest performance in this series. You know what I'm saying? As Will's, Lisa's father pretty much takes a liking of Will and stuff like that too. And he wants to be all in their lives and whatnot too. I love the scene when Nia Long delivers his line when she says, "Will, this is all your fault. You are just so lovable." So shit, I died laughing when she said that. You know what I'm saying? The more I watch this season, I'm not going to hold you. I felt like they definitely had some very great chemistry and whatnot, too, you know what I'm saying? But it is what it is. Love this episode. And then next you have Willis from Mars. My favorite episode of this season. You know what I'm saying? This is when, you know, the marriage counseling episode, when Will and Lisa have a regular argument, so they get marriage counseling. And whom do they see? None other than the Jeffersons. You know, Sherman Hemsley and Isabel Sanford return. Sherman Hemsley actually playing the George Jefferson character. You know, I've seen some people's comment about this episode, and they pretty much say that the writing for the Jeffersons was a bit more broader, more mean-spirited. You know what I'm saying? Especially with this scene when George was like, "Your mama died, your mama dead, your mama not coming back." I'm not going to hold you. I did die laughing when he said that. You know what I'm saying? And it doesn't really capture the true essence of what makes Jeffersons great. However, I do feel like it's one of the funniest episodes, because the marriage counseling scene alone was just joke after joke after joke, revealing a lot of character moments between Will and Lisa. The fight between Will, George, Louise, and Lisa was very iconic too, with the bops, probably a nod to the season 2 episode when George and Louise, Helen and Tom had that marriage counseling fight too, which again, you can pretty much put this on the same level of Ashes to Ashes as a homage to the Jeffersons itself. You know what I'm saying? So, very important episode. My favorite episode of the whole Will and Lisa arc. A very, very, very classic episode. And so now we get to the season 6. And, yeah, season 6 is actually my least favorite. My least favorite season. I'm going to be real with you. And again, originally season 5 was supposed to be the last season, but they wanted to bring the show back, as evidence in the last episode of season 5, you know what I'm saying? So, with Will Smith being a popular movie star, you know, with Bad Boys coming out and Independence Day coming out that summer, he really wanted to focus more on his movie career. So, not only did he end the show, he actually made himself an executive producer too. I'm gonna be real with you. Season 6 has some of the worst episodes of the season of the series. However, I do feel like they ended it at the right time because there were still some entertaining episodes. A lot of episodes, not gonna hold you, was just retreads of earlier episodes, but again, capturing the Martin tone that we captured in the previous season, it does kind of have that entail to it. But believe it or not, there was still some good shit, and the finale actually ended out very well. First episode of the season, Burning Down the House. You know, this was written by Joel Madison, Adam Markowitz, and Madeline Karp. You know, this has Will burning down the kitchen. A nice explosive start to the season, you know what I'm saying? And again, we've seen episodes like this. This is pretty much a retread of the whole. This is pretty much a retread of the whole episode of Butler Did It, when the whole living room got messed up in the Belleville Devote video. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, this one was very funny. You know what I'm saying? Will trying to rush and clean the kitchen was very funny. You know, trying to not make Uncle Phil worry, especially when he has a guest coming over. I mean, it is what it is. And then we have episode 5 of the season, Script Formerly Known As. So this is an episode I don't hear a lot of people talking about. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like it's a very funny episode throughout. This was written by Felicia D. Henderson, who actually, you know, did work on shows like Moesha and Sister Sister. You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, she was a co-producer of Moesha and a co-executive producer of Sister Sister. You know what I'm saying, too? So, like, during, like, the latter seasons, of course. So, you know what I'm saying? So, it's pretty much, you know, Philip, you know, witnessing the news that two jurors were dismissed. And Will actually met one of the jurors, played by the very funny comedian George Wallace. And he's on a guest in the Hillary show. And pretty much, he's just blasting Uncle Phil on the air. And it's very, very, very funny. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, Will and Hillary trying to make it up to Uncle Phil. I call it one of the few original episodes of this season. I'm not going to hold you. I did love this scene when Will pretty much, you know, lip syncs. And I'm telling you, I'm not going by Jennifer Holliday. Yeah, this is one of the more funnier episodes of this season. It's broad, but not too broad. So, I can accept it. Moving on to episode 7, Not With My Cousin You Don't. You know what I'm saying? So, believe it or not, a very great Ashley episode that guest stars Jaleel White, aka Steve Urkel. So Ashley is considering losing her virginity to her boyfriend, you know what I'm saying, played by, of course, Jaleel White. And, you know, again, you know, this is pretty much a redone episode of the episode in season 2 when Ashley is, you know, questioning about sex, but this time now she wants to have some sex. You know what I'm saying? So one of the more better consistent retreads that they've done. You know what I'm saying? But the real reason why I put this episode on the list is because of the natural conversation between Ashley and Hillary in this episode, because of the fact that, you know, Ashley going to Hillary for advice. And I'm not going to hold you. While Hillary is not like the dumbest character, you know, sometimes she'll give Ashley some very questionable advice sometimes too. But this is I love the extended scene where it's like really two grown-up sisters, you know, just talking about love and life and whatnot. So I wish they had more scenes like this, but I'll accept it for what it is. So very, very, very great episode. Moving on to season 6, episode 14, Breaking Up Is Hard to Do. So Daphne Maxa Reed as Vivian does not bring out a lot of memorable performances compared to Janet Hubert. You know, Janet Hubert was a tough force to reckon with, to be real with you. So, but I do feel like in this season, she did have a couple of episodes, you know what I'm saying, where I felt like she definitely pretty much, you know, held her own. And the writing for Vivian was pretty much reminiscent of Janet Hubert. So this episode features Uncle Phil and Aunt Vivian pretty much going through a separation arc after Uncle Phil wants to run for politics without telling Aunt Vivian, you know what I'm saying? And yeah, it's a pretty, pretty, pretty interesting episode. I'm not going to hold you. even though I didn't really care too much for the modeling subplot between Ashley, and it did bring out some funny moments between Will and Carlton, especially the whole, I think, the whole puppet episode, puppet scene, you know what I'm saying? I did feel like it was definitely a key development to Ashley, you know, modeling, you know, which would be her career choice after the show ended, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah. When it comes to this two-parter, I love the scene between Daphne Maxwell confronting Leaf and Philip, you know what I'm saying? Her character Leaf and Philip and whatnot. And even though I prefer part one over part two, I do recommend both parts, essentially, so... This one was pretty straight. By the way, part two had a classic scene with Aunt Helen, Will, and Carlton sing and serenade Aunt Viv and Uncle Phil, so I gotta mention that one. Episode 18 of this season, Here Today. So again, another episode where you have second Aunt Viv, you mean, handling a plot of her own when she has to actually fight off the misinterpreted attraction between Reverend Gordon Sims. Again, Richard Roundtree returning to be a guest star in this season, you know what I'm saying? As you know, he guest starred in one of the funniest episodes of the first season, Chubba Bubba. You know what I'm saying? So, it's a very, very, very good showcase for Maxwell Weed, I'll give you that. But the real reason why I put this episode in this list is because of the very, very, very subplot, funny subplot, where Uncle Phil accidentally kills Nikki's pet rabbit, Harry. And I love the studio audience in this episode too. Like, it's like, the first reaction is like, no, no. And then the second reaction is like, oh, he's gonna do it. But then when he actually does it, it's worthwhile. I always rewind the part over and over and over again when it comes to that episode, you know what I'm saying? So... very, 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 very funny episode, and I definitely highly recommend it. Then we're going to get into the Eye Tooth episode. This is the episode with William Shatner. In my opinion, the funniest episode of the season. You know what I'm saying? And it's actually very, very, very funny. Like, above season 6 standards. So William Shatner guest stars, and he's actually a guest host on the Hillary Show. And Carlton is a William Shatner fan because why not? You know what I'm saying? Why not? You know what I'm saying? And, you know, William Shatner takes a liking to Will because he doesn't really want to talk about his career a lot, which Carlton always does. And then they end up breaking William Shatner's tooth with a pool stick. Again, kind of Martin-esque. But, again, that's very funny and shit, too. But then, you know... they end up trying to make matters better and stuff like that too, you know what I'm saying? And they want to actually get him on the show. However, the very, very, very funny moment appears exactly when they get, you know, laugh gassed, and they end up, you know, pretty much ad-libbing the whole scene, if you ask me. A lot of Star Trek references and shit, you know what I'm saying? So... this was a very, 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 very funny episode. And yeah, I like it. No, can't get mad about it. Now, keyword. That's the funniest episode. That's not the best episode of the season. And the best episode is, of course, I Done. The 1 hour series finale. So, it's no surprise. I do feel like this is definitely one of the best finales, in my opinion. And it's a very solid way to end off this series. And the reason why I like it is because the fact that it definitely shows Will still continuing on his journey. And the reason being is because, you know, a lot of fans have said that they didn't really like this finale because of the fact that, oh, well, Will end up not getting anything. And I'm going to be real with you. Sometimes in the series finale, you can't really just have the characters just always get everything literally within a span of 30 minutes or an hour and stuff like that too, because it's rushed, you know what I'm saying? And you know what I'm saying? Pretty much, he still decides he's going to finish school to make something out of his life. And I can accept that, especially with how Will's development was throughout the whole series. You know what I'm saying? He has like his slacker moments, but he didn't really like waste his potential. He didn't really like to just waste his potential like that. You know what I'm saying too? So I can definitely appreciate this episode. You know what I'm saying? And I definitely love the scene when, well, I love a couple of scenes to be real with you. First of all, I love the scene where Will is trying to prevent the son of the house. And he's pretty much greeted by, you know, Arnold, Jackson, Drummond from Different Strokes, you know, Gary Coleman, Conrad Bain. And then you had the Jeffersons returning once again, but this time you had Florence played by the wonderful Marla Gibbs, you know what I'm saying, that they pretty much came back. So this was a very, very, very fun series finale. A lot of other funny moments happened too. Again, a very great talk between Uncle Phil and Will, you know, with Will saying that he feels like he has not really grown and stuff like that too, and Uncle Phil accepting Will as his son. And I love the how he tells the family that every Sunday, no matter where you guys are in life, we always call. You know what I'm saying? And it pretty much just has Carlson going to Princeton, Hillary and Ashley going to Paris, Jeffrey, you know, getting to know his son more. You know what I'm saying? Which, again, they had an episode where his son came back, which, again, that was a pretty good episode, but I just feel like they just kind of rushed that plot. But it's still pretty decent. I'm not going to hold you. And, yeah, you know, Will pretty much, you know, just realizing that he's going to finish school, he's going to make something out of his life. And it just ends the show off like that. And, you know, the end of The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Very, 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 very great show. It was a pleasure actually recounting my favorite episodes. I know some episodes was better than others. I'm not going to hold you. But at the same time, I feel like The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, no matter what season you watch, you're still going to get entertained. You're still going to laugh at certain... You're still going to laugh at certain episodes. You're still going to recite the lines. It's like one of the most timeless sitcoms of all time. And yeah, rest in peace to James Avery. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you guys have a very good day. Peace.